and R&B melodies.
What Andre did is, you know, he just, he changed. He made history with what he did with Uptown. Even before I was there, you know, it was a new jack swing going on.
Hit it.
New Jack Swing married the sonic assault of hip-hop with the melodic traditions of soul music. In promoting it, Uptown Records had helped to launch the sound that became modern R&B.
New Jack Swing was basically what the music is right now. It's a trip because it was big, big heavy bass drum, boom, boom, and, you know, synthesizers and bass.
The style and culture of New Jack Swing was realized in one individual who would become the movement's biggest star, Bobby Brown.
Bobby Brown was the ensign for this new generation. He was the guy driving the Benz. He was the guy buying out the bar. You know, Moet for everybody. It's on me. This guy was really a poster boy for, you know, the street culture.
Unlike the street realness of hip-hop, New Jack Swing was aspirational music, and its stars sported the same designer labels worn by high-rolling street hustlers.
New Jack Swing became this culture of balling and passion and music with a celebration for young people. It always had a dressed-up sound, a slick dressed-up sound with jewelry. If jewelry, and with the jewelry like the diamonds were the champagne bubbles of the party.
The way that I wanna live. It's my life. I can do just what I feel. It's my life. Nobody can tell me what to do.
It was Bobby Brown's explosion onto the music scene in 1988 that turned the R&B industry upside down and signaled that time was finally up for slickly engineered 1980s crossover soul.
He sold 8 million copies of that album. He literally allowed the recording industry to say, you know, there's actually something here around R&B again, right? We can reinvest in what's happening around this notion of New Jack Swing because it speaks to the kids, and now we realize that the kids are, in fact, buying records.
New Jack Swing even affected Whitney Houston, who flirted with the sound in an attempt to restore her credibility with black audiences.
From the moment I saw you,
Whitney's infatuation continued in the flesh when she got engaged to Bobby Brown.
She didn't feel that she was flourishing for some reason. And so she got involved with Bobby Brown. She didn't want one of the Huxtable kids. She wanted a gangster, and she got it.
Whitney eventually tied the knot with Bobby Brown in the summer of 1992, marrying into the sound when New Jack Swing was on a high. But while the black music industry was celebrating the wedding, Uptown Records was ready to capitalize on the success of their own soul diva. Mary J. Blige's career path was overseen by one of Uptown's rising stars, Sean Combs, better known as Puff Daddy.
Puff
Puff Daddy, A&R director of Uptown. My brother, let him know how easy or how difficult or how fly or how complicated it was to put this jam together.
It was no problem because all my black brothers and sisters came together, like my man Dougie Fresh, all the beautiful women out here. We came together just to have a good time, celebrate the Overweight Lovers Party. We out.
Puff Daddy styled Mary to appeal to the youth of black America, giving her a look that would come to be known as Ghetto Fabulous.
Well, he took what he saw when I first came to Uptown. I either had on a pair of baggy jeans or some Timberlands or something, something that made him understand what I was. And he took that and he made it expensive. And he put me in a baggy men's version of an Armani suit, turned my hat backwards, and there was Mary J. Blige looking like hip-hop royalty, but like a dude.
Mary's debut album, What's the 411, opened with a string of answer phone messages to Mary from Puff Daddy and others that dramatized the world she was coming from.
Yo, what's up? This is Mary. I'm not home. Leave a message. Peace.
Yo, Mary, what's up? This is Kurt Juice. Yo, what's up? What's happening? You're late. Come on, hurry up. We got to go get this money.
What's the 411? Definitely with Puffy saying, come on, nigga, we gotta make this money. Like he was talking to a dude.
Hey, Mary, it's Puff. Pick up the phone, nigga. Hey, Mary, it's Puff.
That's how young guys talk to their girls. Like they were talking to another guy. They talk really hard to him. And those women, again, you know, took it like, oh, he loves me. Call me a nigga. He called me a bitch. You know, he really feels for me.
Mary. Mary. Yo, Mary. It's me.
What's the 411? Completed the transformation of R&B into a new musical hybrid.
With the New Jack Swing, she graduated it because she had so much pain and soul in her vocal, and it became hip-hop soul.
Hip-hop soul recycled rap and classic soul records to create new music.
Well, hip-hop soul to me is the ability to be able to take another artist's sample and like ride it like you are a part of, like you were in the band with them.
In the case of Mary's breakout single, Real Love, the beat was lifted straight from a cult hip-hop record by the group Audio 2.
MCMI, people call me Milk. When I'm busting up a party, I feel no guilt. Milk D's rhyming, Milk is chilling, Giz is chilling. What more can I say? Top villain.
We had the Milk is chilling beat, which was a famous rap record beat that was really a teenage beat, and it was simple, straight ahead.
I just wanted to ride the beat and sing. So when you take a Milk is chilling, Giz is chilling, you say Real Love is crazy. Not taking anything out of it. It's still organic.
Uptown marketed Mary as the queen of hip-hop soul. Ghetto royalty singing out to the dysfunctional children of black America.
Mary sang out of pain to express herself. And we were able to take her pain and put it on a platform to be the communicator for all that generation of women who had grew up in the 80s in a single parent decade with crack being the main drug, just taking whole households out. It was bigger than a hit record. It was a generation of women who felt like they were unloved and they had no idea would they ever be loved. And here was this beacon of light singing about it.
She is just this strength and this light and this, and you see her pain, you see what she's been through, and she makes you remember when you've been through that,
yeah.
And sounds good doing it.
So I try my best and pray to God he send me someone real to caress me and to guide me towards the love my heart can feel. Now I know I can be faithful, I can be your all in all. I give you good love and through the summertime, winter, spring, and fall.
The unique combination of Uptown's marketing savvy and the heartfelt soul in Mary's voice made her a star, with what's the 411's lead single, Real Love, making the top 10 in the pop chart.
I was still in the projects, doing the regular things that I do, getting in fights, you know, going through it, you know? It was like, whatever. And then, out of nowhere, Real Love just turned into a bomb. Like, it was like all over the place, and it took me out of the hood. It took my family out of the hood. And I was stuck in the music business.